effective communication between the server and clients is a critical part of building a Roblox experience. As such, understanding the different mechanisms for network communication and how to use them is an important skill. Hey there, this is Steven. Let's learn something new. RemoteEvents and Unreliable RemoteEvents are the particular mechanisms we will look at in this video. Specifically, how do they differ, and how do we choose between the two? Before we dig into the differences, let's gain a high-level understanding of remotes. A remote object, remote event, remote function, or unreliable remote event, is an instance that allows you to send arbitrary data from the server to the client, or from the client to the server. The word remote typically refers to communication between devices. We might send important information from the server to the client, such as their loaded game data, or the name of the next map about to load. The client might use remotes to ask the server to perform certain actions. For example, the client might ask the server to enter into a vehicle, or to remove an item from the client's inventory. However, this doesn't answer our question. What is the difference between a remote event and an unreliable remote event? Let's first take a look at networking off of Roblox, which will give us some important context. Networking is complicated. We are going to take a very high-level look at some networking concepts. Don't worry, there's no test at the end. In general, networking allows us to remotely communicate between computers. But this process isn't foolproof. When we want to send a chunk of data from one device to another, a lot of things need to go right. If anything goes wrong, our data might become corrupted, or might not even reach its destination. So, if we want to have some level of guarantee that our data reaches its destination, we need to do some extra work. One such protocol is TCP, Transmission Control Protocol. This protocol has a lot of back and forth communication between the sender and receiver to help ensure the data reaches its destination. This protocol is great for a majority of web traffic, such as loading web pages, images, and other static content. But all of this back and forth comes at a time and data cost. What happens when we want to stream a lot of data, like watching a live stream of our favorite game? In such a scenario, TCP would slow us down significantly. To solve this problem, we can reach for a second protocol called UDP, User Datagram Protocol. This protocol is dead simple. We send a request to the streaming server, and the streaming server starts sending response after response of the data we want. At the protocol level, there are no extra checks being done here, no acknowledgements, nothing. If the data fails to arrive, too bad. If the data is corrupt, too bad. But in a streaming environment, this is fine because we can skip over a frame or two without too much disruption. It's not critical for every piece of data to arrive in order or at all. Okay, class dismissed. How does this relate to Roblox? Remote events act similar to the TCP protocol, where delivery of our data is guaranteed to arrive and arrive in the same order it was sent. Unreliable remote events act similar to the UDP protocol, where our delivery is not guaranteed, nor is the order. Standard or reliable remote events may use a bit more data since there is a bit of back and forth over the wire to ensure things are all good. Generally, this is okay and preferred. However, depending on our network overhead, there might be aspects of our experiences that perform better with unreliable remote events. Bogging down the network can lead to a lot of complications. If we bottleneck our network with data we're sending through remote events, other critical data might get blocked, such as replication of moving assemblies in our game. This might show up as lag or stuttering and generally leads to a poor user experience. Using unreliable remote events may help alleviate some of the network pressure, since unreliable events may be dropped if needed, and no extra network traffic is necessary to ensure delivery or order. When should you use one or the other? Knowing how to see our network overhead is a good first start. There's a few different spots we can look at to see this data. One is the network stats overlay. Another is the network section under the performance window. And another is the performance stats window in-game. These tools help us see how much data is flowing in and out. If we're not seeing anything concerning, such as large spikes in our send or receive categories, then we might not need to do anything. Here are some rule of thumbs to loosely follow. 1. If you're unsure of which one to use, default to the standard remote event. 2. If the data is critical to arrive on either end, or the order is critical, use a standard remote event. For instance, any data critical to game state. 3. If you are sending a stream of data, such as bits of data at a high frequency, then unreliable remote events might be a better fit. And 4. Unreliables have a max data size of 900 bytes per event, so you must use a standard remote event when sending more data than this. Roblox will simply drop any unreliable events that exceed this data limit. Let's take a look at a couple of examples. Example 1, replicating player data. A common task is to send clients their user data. This data might include things like points, money, unlocked items, etc. Consider what we need for this to work. 1. The data isn't sent very often. 2. The amount of data could be quite high, at least for the first send. We could reduce this overhead on subsequent sends by diffing our data. 3. The data is critical to the user experience. And 4. Having the data fail to arrive would not be okay. With this information, we know that a standard remote event is what we need. When our player data is loaded, we'll fire it off to the client using a remote event, and we can know that our client will receive the data. Example 2, laser pointer. Let's create a laser pointer. It's a simple concept. Whenever the player points the mouse, we want to do a simple ray cast and draw a line to where the ray hits. This is simple to do on the client, but what if we want to replicate this to all the other clients? We need to first send our laser pointer data to the server and then let the server broadcast that data to the other clients. Consider what we need for this to work. 1. The data needs to be sent very often, probably every frame, or at least when the player's laser pointer moves. 2. The amount of data is pretty small, just position and direction of the laser pointer. 3. The data is not critical to the game state. And 4. It's okay if the data fails to arrive sometimes, or is out of order periodically. This is a great use case for unreliable remote events. Let's use one to replicate our data to the other clients. Let's create an unreliable remote event for our network communication, and then create a server script to shuttle our data from one client to the rest. Our server script will simply take data it receives and rebroadcast it to all the clients. On the client, we'll receive this data and draw the line just like we were doing before. We'll ensure that it's not our client, since we've already drawn the laser for our local client. To demonstrate network strain, I have used a third-party tool to simulate 200 milliseconds of lag, 10% chance of packet drop, and a 10% chance of out of order. Notice how the laser pointer, while a little jittery, continues to work as expected. Let's swap to a normal remote event and see what happens. Notice how the laser pointer seems to struggle to keep up. Let's see these side by side for a quick comparison. You can see how unreliable remote events can really shine in tough networking situations. Networking can be hard, but I hope we've demystified a small bit of it today. Remember to keep an eye on your network usage when testing your game and think critically about what data should be reliably sent versus unreliably sent. If you want to learn more, check out the documentation pages on remote events and unreliable remote events. Links below.